Tyler here with GP Knives, wishing you a happy International Coffee Day. And back by popular demand with this knife, the Benchmade Mini Loco. We've had some people requesting that we compare it to another knife, the Spyderco Mannix 2. Similar lock operation on these two, but a little bit different in the overall design. I also think that the Mini Loco compares nicely to one of my favorite EDCs, the Spyderco Cali 3.5. As you can see, these knives both have a similar cant to the handle, and while they do have a different design function, they are both very similar in the ergonomics. We're going to compare the Mini Loco to a couple of other knives as well, and then we've also got in the house the Lion Steel M1, a nice little fixed blade made from Bowler M390, and we're going to touch on that briefly as well. So here we have the Benchmade Mini Loco. We got a Mannix 2 in the laminate blade and peel-ply carbon fiber. We got a DPX Hest over here, and then the new Lion Steel M1 fixed blade. Now you can see these are all fairly similar in the size. The mechanisms on these two are going to actuate in a similar fashion. You're going to pull the ball bearing lock down this way, pull the axis lock down this way. Now what you'll notice here is that the Loco still has a little more cutting edge in a shorter blade, no choil on that one, and it does have a thicker blade stock and a more robust tip there, thanks to the high height saber grind versus that full flat grind. So while the Mannix 2 is going to have probably a little advantage in terms of the slicing performance, you can also see that the height of the grind there on the Loco is going to provide plenty of slicing performance while still maintaining a more robust tip for hard use. You're still getting a slightly more compact handle length. You can see the end of the handle here, and that is in part due to the angle of the handle there. And the overall thickness in the handles is actually going to be a little bit higher on the Mannix 2. Now I've got the DPX up here. I think these are a little more comparable in the robustness of the build. You can see the DPX is a little thicker, but has a very similar thickness at the tip. And you get a little more cutting edge on the Benchmade, thanks to that canted handle design. And then the actual handle length on these two is going to be pretty similar. Handle thickness is going to go to the DPX, much more robust in the handle thickness there, thanks to that titanium frame lock construction. But overall, I think these two are actually pretty comparable and both come from the same design thinking in terms of a robust, hard-use folding knife. And we'll touch briefly on the Lion Steel M1. About the same cutting edge as the Mannix 2. Thickness is very similar at the spine, slightly more robust tip there. Handle thickness is going to be a little higher thanks to those contoured G10 scales, but the overall package is nice and compact. Get a full four-finger grip on there, and then that nice titanium lanyard bead to help draw it from the leather sheath. Again, this is Tyler with GP Knives wishing you a happy International Coffee Day. Thanks for watching, and stay sharp. If you like what you've seen today and you'd like to see more, check out the rest of the videos on our YouTube channel. Like the video below, and click the icon at the bottom right-hand corner to subscribe to our YouTube channel feed for updates on all new videos.